Hi, beautiful people. It's Talk to Mama. It's great to be back with you again. How are you doing? Well, I promised, remember? I said, I think about 2 posts ago, when I was talking about the trending issue of paternity fraud, I guess that's what they call it. All right. And I said, well, what exactly is going on? Why are we having these issues now? Is there something behind it? Is it new? Or has it always been there? Is it as a result of, you know, the environment, digital age, you know, whatever? I said, well, there is a need to talk to an expert. All right. Now, I'm happy to tell you that I've got an expert. Yes. A psychologist. Actually, she's working on this right now. See what I mean? Who better? Who is it, you know, that is better put to discuss this issue but this expert? All right. So, remember, the show is about helping the vulnerable ones in our society. Talk to Mama. Please remember, subscribe and call on all your friends to subscribe to this channel. And remember, click on the notification button so that you will know when I upload all my videos. And check the description box. The box, yes, down there, you will find the information about this show. All right? So, relax now. Let's go meet our expert. She's going to introduce herself. Welcome to our show, ma'am.
Thank you very much, ma.
We're happy to have you.
Thank you, ma.
Let's meet you.
My name is Oyetunji Alemide Mrs. I am a psychologist. I work with Obafemi Awolowo University. I'm a social psychologist, and my area of research interest is in family and marriage.
Good. That's very so. We're on the right path. So we have really come to the right person. Good. Good. Now, what is trending in our society today? It's this issue of paternity fraud. And, you know, we really want to make, try to make sense of, you know, the whole thing. All right, first, as an expert, let's hear from you. What exactly would you describe as paternity fraud? Maybe we'll have different aspects of
okay. Paternity is all about who fathers a child, and when there is a dispute in who owns this child, then the issue of paternity for comes in. People begin to wonder, okay, if a woman is gives birth to a child, everybody is expects that child to belong to the husband, and when there are controversy over the legitimacy of that child, then there is a big question mark. People start asking, okay, how do we verify who is the rightful owner of the child? That's where this issue of paternity fraud comes in.
All right, before we go that far, I want to look at our society. We're Africans. Nigerians, and in African society, we do not believe that there are bastards. You know, every child must have a father. So why then do we begin to talk about paternity fraud? Does that mean that some women are not faithful to their husband.
To their husband. Thank you very much, Ma. From the beginning of time, we know that when there is a marriage, there is bound to be production of children. And in a pure African society, we believe that it is the father that owns a child. So that makes paternity an important factor in every home. So the situation then was that every child that is born into a marriage belongs to the husband. Mm-hmm. It is now that we begin to see situations where there is controversy over who owns a child. Every child that is being born into a family belongs to the man. That is the understanding of a pure African man. Mm-hmm. Until it is proven otherwise. Mm-hmm. And the situation we are seeing today is alien to us in Africa.
Well,
where you have to start looking deep into who exactly the father of a child is.
Well, maybe because the technology has advanced and now it's possible, and there we say easier, you know, to actually find out who exactly does this person belong to. All right?
Even prior to the advance of technology, sometimes when you look at a child, you can say this child belongs to this person or not. The physical features and even behavior of a child will point attention to whoever the father of a child is. And in those days, you don't even need anybody to tell you. Once you see a child, some people will say it's as if the person opened his mouth and bring the child out.
Exactly.
You know, the way you look like. And in family, there is always a resemblance.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, my own brother's kids looks like me.
Mm.
So when you,
the gene.
Yes, the gene is there. And some people's genes are so strong that once you see their offspring, you can determine that, oh, this person fathers this child.
All right. Now, since we have these scenarios and, let's go to the, meat of the issue itself. What on earth would make a woman married legally and culturally married to a man to now go out of that enclosed circle to now go out and meet and make a baby with another man? What manner of psyche would do that?
Thank you.
Help us make sense of this.
In Africa, so much value is placed on childbearing.
Mm-hmm.
And the fault is adduced to the woman.
Mm-hmm.
Every marriage that produces no offspring is the fault of the woman. So for a woman to retain her marriage, she has to give birth.
Hmm.
And that desperacy pushes some women out. Some will go to some will go even within the family, maybe to their in-laws, the husband's younger brother and other family members to raise kids. Even in those days, it's not a new thing. It's been happening.
Wow.
Sometimes even the mother-in-law can be involved in some cases. We have seen cases where mother-in-laws are involved, especially when it is the fault of the man.
Mm-hmm.
When it is the man that has the problem,
right. They
want to conceal it within the family.
Right.
And they will advise the woman, so you can still raise kids within this family.
Mm-hmm.
But when it is a situation that it is the woman who has the problem, they will show the woman the way out of the family.
Hmm.
So most of the time, in order to cover the shame of the man, the woman is advised to raise kids for the man. And it becomes a concealed issue that doesn't go out of the family.
So if we can say that, you know, our culture is actually behind this, I didn't want to use the word sacrilegious, you know, acts. Women over the centuries or decades, as the case may be, have also deduced ways of coping, you know, with the issues, you know, of
barrenness,
and of course even their image, their personality, you know, in trying to build a good image for themselves, and you know, trying to maintain their hope within the family system, you know, they've discovered, you know, ways of coping. So you're trying to say that it's a way of
preserving the
marriage, you know. So women have decided to take this route, at least to keep themselves within the family. All right, in some other cases, for some women who got involved in this thing, it's not the case, you know. They've had, you know, one or two children for their husband, and it's outright infidelity. You know, you get to know of, you know, a woman whose number one, two children belong to the husband, and then three, four belong to the best friend of the husband. You know, what about that?
Those, I understand, those are exceptional cases.
Yeah.
And because some of them have done it and nothing happened, so it becomes trendy. Now, for a woman, that's why when a woman is joined to a man, they usually advise that you should leave every other relationship. You should get out of every other relationship. For instance, I may have been having somebody I was as a good friend, and the moment I get married, I have to cut myself off those relationships. The moment you still
maintain
outside relationships, there is tendency for you to bring other children home for your husband. And there are even some women that it doesn't matter. That's their own way of life. They just jump from one man to another. Some have a relationship even with their domestic workers. And sometimes we may not outrightly blame the parties involved. The man may be the type that doesn't give attention to the woman at all, and the woman is trying to get the attention from elsewhere. And before she knew what is happening, she has defiled the marital the sacredness of the marriage. And in some situations, some women are just promiscuous, and they are never satisfied with their husbands, and they go from one place to another, and they are not satisfied. There are so many reasons, from one person to another. There is this individual differences in the reasons. In fact, if we go out now to interview some people, you will hear different opinions, different reasons why people engage in different things. But I believe today's trend of events is because we are seeing situations that calls for tests. For instance, I want to travel abroad, and I need to show that these kids belongs to me. Those are the situations that brought many of these things out, issues out. If not, there wouldn't have been. Nobody would have known. And let me tell you today, if you go from house to house, you will discover a lot. Many things are happening in many homes. It's the one we are hearing that we know. In fact, there are so many that are coming out after the experience of this trendy banker
case. Exactly.
Many other ones that has been buried before are now coming out.
Yes.
So the culture of silence is another issue.
The culture of
Culture of silence. You know, even when things like that happens, you want to cover the shame. You don't want to be ridiculed. Even the man, even when the man knows, the man does not do anything because he feels it becomes a shameful thing.
It's embarrassing to
you know, it's embarrassing. And another thing is, there's always a place of forgiveness also, coming from the point of view of the religious. You should be able to forgive if you have taken a vow that for better, for worse.
So that's the worst aspect.
And when the worst aspect comes, you have to deal with the worst aspect. And you cover it up. If you still love your wife, you forgive. Wow. So there are different issues. And many people have forgiven their wife for bringing such into their homes. And that's why nobody is hearing about them. So in this, in the case of this banker that is trending, I'm very sure that that is what is bringing out quite a number of such. And if we continue like this, many worms will come out of the can.
But then is there, I understand, I get it. Our society, our culture, you know, is complicit. Fine. But what about the individuals, you know, involved? I mean, what? Because for me, I don't know. Is this same culture, for example, the Yoruba culture, that taught us that no matter what, even at the risk of your life, you should be honest in all things. So I'm trying to understand the, you know, the mindset that will decide to go ahead with a barbaric, you know, quote unquote, a barbaric idea like that. Because, I mean, in some cases, maybe rare, some persons may say, look, whatever it is, this is wrong and I cannot go along with it. You know, but what kind of, is it because our culture, or we have been schooled, you know, in the ways of our culture, that we don't deploy our own sensibility, you know, to fight this kind of barbarism?
I wouldn't call it barbarism.
Okay.
The reason why I wouldn't call it barbarism is this. You know, in the olden days, you know, it is men's world. Anything a man does, he goes away with it.
Okay.
When your husband have kids outside, he brings them home, and they will ask you to accept it. And you have no option than to just take it. But now, this is a period where women feels whatever a man does, I can also do. We have equal rights. So if my husband is cheating, why can't I cheat? And that is what brought so many women into this kind of situation.
Wow.
There are some who have had two kids for their husband. And because the husband is a perpetual cheat, and the woman feels, what is it? If you are cheating, why can't I cheat? In the moment, in the course of the woman going out to do like her husband, to cheat, she must have forgotten that the man will come back home without pregnancy. And in an attempt to do what the man is doing, you know, there's a say, what a man can do, a woman can also do. A woman can also do. But the fact remains that it doesn't happen the same way. The consequences of those actions are not the same. So when the woman wants to be like a man and goes out to do such things, it becomes shameful.
So it's a reaction against patriarchy, you're trying to say.
I think we can look in that direction.
And it seems to be backfiring, isn't it? So maybe it's time to go deeper in deconstructing patriarchy. And well, I mean, that's for you researchers in that area to try and see, you know, how better to deconstruct the, you know, the overarching hegemonic patriarchy that is with us here in Africa.
Well, that's the show for today. I really hope you have picked some very interesting points there. So many controversial issues coming out from our expert. All right. Well, at the end of it all, we'll get to do a bit of analysis of all we have picked from her. Anyway, that's the first part for now. In my next post, you get to meet her again for the second part of that interview. All right. I hope you've enjoyed the show. Please tell others about it. Talk to Mama is here. It's to help vulnerable ones, to talk about issues that actually make us vulnerable and see how we can cope. All right. Talk to Mama, darling. You will get a relief.